Who's that? Watch it! You rumpled my best suit.
I said give me a drink. Move it, move it!
Move it doesn't buy you a drink around here.
Hey, you. You know what I think when I look out from here?
Yes.
People are robbing each other, fighting wars. Said give me a drink. Move it, move it!
Move it doesn't buy you a drink around here.
Hey, you.
I'm tired of living. How much longer must we slave away for that, George?
At least he pays. Anyway, we can't return to Marshes.
Look at you. The Mage Factory's captain of the guard. And such a poor liar.
What do you mean?
A charge of treason, Titus. But to be honest, I still don't know. What are you, really?
Are you a coward who deserted his post in a crisis? Or a villain who deliberately doomed the people of MONPATRIS.
Very well. You win. Let me unburden my conscience. Two aristocrats came to the Mage Factory that night, their faces hidden under masks. They had a guest pass from Palatinus, the mage from the lab who's in charge of poisons. Then there was an explosion that made the ground shake. We're guards, you know, not heroes. We ran so fast you'd think Ulogi was chasing us.
Of what use are you to me? You saw nothing.
Of course I bolted. Do you have any idea what Palatinus is capable of? I do. One of my men once stepped in a colorful puddle near the laboratory. He and the man in the bunk next to him suffered a horrible death. Two more lost their minds. And for what? For the good of Nostria and His Majesty? That night I heard cries from Palatinus' laboratory. An explosion and some shouts were enough for me. I ran and took my people with me. I ran as far as I could.
So this is all the fault of that mage, Palatinus. Can you prove it?
What do you think? Here it is, the guest letter, with his signature. And his personal seal. Take it. Hang me or pardon me, your choice. I might be a coward, but our spears are of no use against poison.
tired of living here. How much longer must we slave away for that torch?
At least he pays. Important person.
You can speak to me? Really? Is it time to become one with the Creator?
I don't think so. You can't even let go of this lonely skull. It's a wonder you haven't dissolved into nothing.
'Tis true. I know more about the afterlife than anyone. And my experiences of the past few centuries have been uncanny indeed. How do I possess all this knowledge? What man am I? Or woman? It has all been erased from my memory, faded with the long march of time. Why am I yet bound to this world?
It appears you are cursed, just as I am. Do you wish my sympathy?
I know not. Could it be that I need time to recollect who I am? Someone scattered my bones over the marshes, and I can feel something connected to me in the very middle of it. My immortality is a heavy burden. If only I could find a way to become one with creation. The one who lies here, beneath my bones, witnessed a mighty assault. An army charging through the blossoming hills towards the walls of the town. He walked among the undead, risen by black necromancy and fear. If an arrow fired from the walls of Marcella did not kill him, that fear would.
That reminds me of an old family legend. Could you perhaps be speaking of my ancestor?
I wouldn't know. My bones were brought here to be secreted away. A woman, a powerful sorceress, wept over them. She lamented for all those fallen, while serving a knight by the name of Baldwin. All those cloven by dwarven axes, or pierced by the spears of the undead. The mourner's magic protected those warriors slain by the necromancers. But centuries have passed. And all that is left of her tears are the ghost lilies.
So that's why only ghost lilies grow here.
Yes, they are but an echo of those time-worn spells.
Thank you.
The fair knight Baldwin led the Marcellan army into battle. This is the spot where Baldwin's protector perished. A squire whose name has been lost to the centuries fought to protect his master until his wounds forced him to the ground. The last thing he saw before his eyes went black were the last of Morkholt's units fleeing back to Rigern.
Ah! This is a story of my luckless ancestor Morkholt, huh? It's been 500 years, and still it comes up.
Yes. In truth, it was a long time ago.
So that's what. It was I, Nisevra the Sorcerer, who learned King Maximus was absent on a mission to conquer the elves and led the undead to the walls of Marcella. What would the Dukes of Rigern, Hugo, and Morkholt do without me? Those good-for-nothings. They are but dust under the boots of the mighty Masters of Death. Thus thought I, but twin lightning bolts from two of Nevedis's sorceresses reduced me to ash. Separately, I would have thrashed either of them.
Does the mighty Master of Death still remember his oath? Will you serve the blood of Rigger as you did before?
I long for vengeance on all those who lived while I lay dead. You will be but the first victim of the mighty Nisevra.